Well, hello and welcome back to the channel. So this has been a long, long time coming now. So what I'm going to be doing on today's video, feels weird to say that again. I'm going to be looking at checkpoints and how to efficiently hit them to make sure you're getting the quickest times and making sure you're using as much room as possible on the racetrack. Just like you saw in the clip there, you want to be able to avoid doing stuff like this, whilst also going as fast as possible. So I will be showing examples of how the hitbox works on a checkpoint. I'll be using different tracks and examples of ways you can cut corners and just basically make up as much time as possible in the open wheels. This also goes for other race series, such as normal racing, stunt racing. It's just a generalization of how checkpoints work. But as you know, my channel, we're gonna be looking more specifically into the open wheel category. So get ready to sit down, get your coffee, get your drink, get your snack and whatever, and let's dive into this. I hope you enjoy. So this is how a checkpoint looks to you in person. It's a circle and yeah, there's nothing much more to go about it. But this is what the checkpoint actually looks like from an invisible perspective. So around it, you have a box. And if you hit each little bit of this box, even though it looks like you're not in the checkpoint, you will actually be still collecting it. So I'm just drawing little dots here to kind of show, you know, if you were to hit these little edges, you know, if you hit anywhere on the edge of that box, the checkpoint will count towards going towards the next one, which means you can effectively cut time. So this was a track I just quickly created in creator mode, just to kind of like make a basic circuit to show you guys the checkpoints. So look, if you put your car outside of this custom track piece, I'm just using this as a sort of a, you know, measurement to how close you can actually get. But the furthest you can go is if you have your two left wheels on this example over to the far left. As you can see, you hit the checkpoint. So what this means is that basically, as long as you, even if you're cutting a corner like this, even though two wheels went off, as long as you go across the checkpoint at some point with yourself that close to it, it does actually register, which, you know, this cuts a lot of time on a lot of different tracks, which I will be showing an example of next. But look here, you have two wheels off and it's not registering. Really strange that, to be honest. But this just shows how close you can actually get to a checkpoint and still be able to collect it and cut time on corners, on different circuits. I think I show a good example of it here as well, you know, all the way across and, you know, still cut the corner, which is fantastic. Right, on to the next bit. So this is the track, more haste, more speed. And it's especially efficient in these, you know, this little chicane by here. You can see how much you can actually cut out of the corner, like almost all the way across there. And if you hit that right, you can save yourself at least like 2 seconds a lap just in that bit. And the other big time saver is just coming up now. This isn't on any other tracks, but this is specifically just for this track. So once you hit this checkpoint by here, all the way over to the left, you're at least saving yourself for about a second a lap there as well, which is absolutely insane. So if you want to up your time on this track, that is how you do it. So this is from Lap It Up. As you can see, I'm specializing the low grip physics in the game by staying on the other side of the circuit, which there is a video on which I'll link up now. So going into this corner, this is where you can really make up some time. So you want to be able to cut over, bring it all the way out to the right, and then swing it over to the left. And you can still hit all those checkpoints and save yourself at least 2 seconds. So this next one is keeping track. As you can see, maximizing all the space as much as possible. And this example that I'm showing also goes for top of town, just basically any track with low, low speed hairpins. So coming up into this section now, although I don't hit it perfectly here, bring it over to the right and swing it as much and tight to the left as possible to save yourself time. Also with a double left like this, bring it over. So then you can set yourself up nicely for the next corner. And this is how you can use checkpoints to your advantage to save time. And yeah, just keep going faster. So this is the last example I'm using on Life's a Beach. I'm just going to kind of let the gameplay roll out because I've kind of, you know, I'm using all the techniques that I've already talked about in the video about checkpoints, all apply to this track as well. So what I'm going to use this time for is kind of speaking about where the channel's going and what I'm going to be doing. So I'm going to be releasing some tips and tricks on contact races and how to run them the best, how many players you should have, different maneuvers you can do to outwit your opponent, especially in open wheels. I'm also going to be delving into the Hot Ring series as well at some point, just to give tips for like online races on that, car setups on that as well. You know, as there's a big player base for that on GTA as well, and it'd be nice to give those players not an advantage, but, you know, ways that they can get faster when other players already know these techniques. So, we have come to the end of the video, and I hope there's something in here you can take away to help improve your lap times, just improve general racing in GTA as well, and have a bit more of an understanding so it doesn't all feel so unfamiliar, because I've had a lot of comments in the past about, you know, to do checkpoints and stuff, so I'm really glad that I could finally make this video and bring it out to you. So until next time, stay safe, stay beautiful, and keep racing.